You're listening to Rebel Air Force. This is House of Cards on the radio. If you like politics, you've probably seen House of Cards, and you probably think, why the fuck would I want to listen to it? I'm making it for myself so that later I can listen to it, because I have a feeling if I'm driving somewhere, it would be kind of cool to be able to listen to my favorite TV show. Just a thought. So we'll see how it goes. The commercials are just finishing up. Just give it a try. Tell me if you think it's cool to listen to a TV show, because this show is all about knowledge and about words. So listening to it will boil it down to you. I'm Alex Weinstein. This is Rebel Air Force. Listen to House of Cards.
You need a haircut.
You think?
A little trim. What are you going to wear?
For the meeting?
For the announcement.
I'm wearing my navy blue on the pinstripes.
Good. You look handsome in that suit.
I don't know if they'll announce before your board meeting.
Well, as long as I can say the donation is coming.
As soon as it's official, Sam Roper will write you the check.
This is going to be a big year for us.
Sorry, Mr. Hammerschmidt. Zoe. Barnes.
Right.
Did it take him a year to remember your name?
Longer.
Good morning, Lucas.
What can I do for you, Zoe?
I am sick of the Fairfax County Council.
You tell me every day.
Move me online. My own blog. First person, subjective, 500 words.
Not gonna happen.
I'll go underground, back rooms, the urinals. I'll win over staff members on the Hill. They need a place to vent.
A gossip column.
No, we lift the veil. What's really going on?
This is the Washington Herald, Zoe. It's not TMZ.
Do you know how many people watch TMZ?
I couldn't care less.
Which is why print journalism is dying.
Then it'll die with dignity, at least at this paper.
You are stuck in the 20th century, Lucas. You lack imagination.
Maybe so, but right now I don't need imagination. I need copy. Your nights and weekends are yours. I applaud whatever you want to do, as long as it's not on my time.
You're telling me to get back to work.
I am.
What you're really telling me is to fuck off.
I'm telling you both.
It's Mr. Chapman, already from Province Trust.
Hold my calls, Christina. Henry.
Good to see you.
How long are you in town for?
Just today.
But you gotta come back down for the inauguration.
I can hook you up. How about you hook me up with the zoning laws you promised to get changed? We got $12 million sitting in escrow for an empty lot we can't build on.
I know, but you gotta understand, it's a local municipal issue. I can't just pick up the phone.
You can't? Because that's not what you led us to believe when you begged for $50,000 in donations.
Right. One sec. Hey, Christina, I said no calls, not while I'm meeting with Mr. Chapman. President-elect. Do you mind?
Well, go ahead, please.
For Christina. Mr. President-elect? Thank you. Yes, we were pleased to win by double digits. Absolutely, anything you need.
I need you to put your long, wet, talented tongue between my thighs and make me squeal like Monica Lewin.
Me too. Me too. Okay. Thank you, sir. I'm so sorry. Where were we?
Walker. What's he like?
President-elect running late.
No, he couldn't make it. I'll brief him, though.
Okay.
This is the memo I've drafted on our Middle East policy we've been developing. Now, I want to borrow from Reagan. I'd like to coin the phrase trickle-down diplomacy. That way...
I'm going to stop you there. We are not nominating you for Secretary of State. I know he made you a promise, but circumstances have changed.
The nature of promises, Linda, is that they remain immune to changing circumstances.
Garrett has thought long and hard about this, and he's decided we need you to stay in Congress.
When was this decision made? And why wasn't I part of a conversation?
I'm sorry, Frank. If it had been up to me, I wouldn't have waited this long to tell you.
So you knew you were going to do this?
It has been an evolving discussion.
It's a chicken shit move.
Frank.
I was vetted. Was that a ruse?
No.
Let's be absolutely clear. You wouldn't have won without me.
You're right. But now we have to lead. And that means making tough choices. As you know, education is a top priority for us, a complete federal overhaul. But it's not just education, Frank. Congress is split. We need you there more than we need you in the State Department.
I got you hired, Linda.
I know.
Donations, endorsements. I wrote the campaign's entire foreign policy platform. I bring years of foreign affairs committee...
Frank, please.
I want to speak to Walker personally.
The decision is made. We need you, Frank. Will you stand beside us or not?
Of course, if that's what the president wants.
I'm very glad to hear that.
I'm curious. If not me, then who?
Michael Kern.
Michael Kern? Well, that is an excellent choice.
Can we make it real clear? I just want to make sure it doesn't look like we're neglecting our domestic...
No. I'm going to say that we're expanding our mission.
Okay.
And we're bringing on a new organization to help us.
Do you know which one yet?
I'm still looking into a few options, but tell me, what did we agree on that we could hire how many new people? Six?
Six, maybe seven.
Hmm?
We'll have enough. Oh, it's exciting, huh? This new direction we're heading. I just don't know where we're going to fit all the people.
Well, do you think we have to look into additional space?
No. I'll find a way.
Okay, so make the changes to the PowerPoint. Let's meet again at 2:30.
Okay.
It's me. I feel like an idiot leaving messages like this. Call me back.
What is it, Zoe?
I know you're going to have your hands full at the White House, so if you need someone to do research or punch out background...
I think I'll be fine.
Well, things get hectic, and you need any help.
So you can blog about rubbing shoulders with the big boys?
What did Lucas tell you?
Look, no offense, Zoe, but I don't have time to be anyone's training wheels.
I just thought... No, I was actually offering to lend a hand. That's it.
Got it. Thanks.
You didn't call.
I was...
You didn't call me, Francis. 9 hours. You don't not call me. Not when it's this big.
You're right.
When have we ever avoided each other?
I wanted the solution first.
Do you have one?
Not yet.
This affects me too, Francis. And it's not the money I'm upset about. It's that we do things together. When you don't involve me, we're in free fall.
I should have called you, and I didn't.
What happened?
She says they need to keep me in Congress.
Linda said that?
Walker wasn't even there. That's what really gets me. He didn't have the courage to look me in the eye.
I know you shouldn't trust that woman.
I didn't. I don't. I don't trust anyone.
Then how could you not see this coming?
I never thought they were capable.
You don't usually underestimate people, Francis.
I know. Hubris. Ambition.
You should be angry.
I'm livid.
Then where is that? I don't see it.
What do you want me to do? Scream and yell? Throw a tantrum?
I want more than I'm seeing. You're better than this, Francis.
Well, I'm sorry, Claire. I am sorry.
No, that I won't accept.
What?
Apologies. My husband doesn't apologize. Even to me.
Sharks love blood.
President-elect Garrett Walker is just...
Why do you think they went with him?
They're too good. They can't afford to lose us in Congress.
He's had work done. Chin tug, probably. Definitely dyes his hair. Do we say anything?
No. God, no. Not unless he brings it up.
Nancy! Cancel everything. Stamper, you're with me. Now, look. They've done us a great favor, Doc. We are no longer bound by allegiances. We serve no one. We live by one rule and one rule only. Never again will we allow ourselves to be put in such a position.
Walker and Vasquez.
All of them. I hold them all accountable.
Retribution?
No, no. It's more than that. Take a step back. Look at the bigger picture.
I think I see what you're getting at. Kern first?
That's how you devour a whale, Doug. One bite at a time.
Who would you want for Secretary of State?
Give me a list of choices. And however we do this, we'll also need a buffer.
You mean an errand boy?
Yes, someone we control completely.
I'll get my ear to the ground.
Good. I haven't eaten since yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
choose to be put on that planet. When I carve him up and toss him to the dogs, only then will he confront that brutal, inescapable truth. My God, all I ever amounted to was chitlins.
And he that shall humble himself shall be exalted. Matthew chapter 23, verse 12. I'd like to speak today on the subject of humility. A lot of you have just won re-election. If you hadn't, you might not be sitting here. And of course, we should enjoy our success and be grateful for it. But never let your gratitude sour into pride. You'll have many challenges ahead over the next couple of years. And a person's character isn't determined by how he or she enjoys victory, but rather how he or she endures defeat. Nothing can help us endure dark times better than our faith.
Claire.
Oh, hello, Felicity.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Sorry. It's just my fault. Charles and I can't understand what Walker was
saying. Oh, that's very sweet.
But really, between you and me, I think Francis is relieved. He just feels much more at home in Congress.
I would have bet $1 million they were going to pick you.
Well, it's a good thing you have $1 million to spare.
But you are by far and away the only choice.
I appreciate you saying that.
I mean, Michael, come on. He's got half the experience.
Garrett is a smart man. He knows what he's doing.
You're a bigger man than I, Frank.
Definitely.
Man, this is some good shit. Where'd you get it?
I kind of lifted it from the VIP room of the speaker's holiday party.
I'm impressed. Bordeaux, 20 years old.
Oh, it seemed about right for you.
Ouch. Why would you say that to me?
I'm almost 30. It's practically ancient in your book.
I don't discriminate when it comes to age.
Really? When was the last time you hired a 40-year-old staffer?
Doesn't mean it wouldn't.
As long as she's good in the sack.
Come on.
That's true, isn't it?
Where is this coming from?
You're not gonna just toss me aside for some slut straight out of Vassar.
Sorry, I'm in that conversation.
It's been 6 months. It's not a little office fling anymore.
You want me to say those three magic words, one of which starts with an L.
Oh, okay.
I'll say them. Christina Gallagher. Lick my balls.
Oh, my God.
I love you. I love you, Christina.
I love you.
Now will you lick my balls? I'm curious, are we patrons, benefactors, or lepers?
Believe it or not, we're angels.
I'm gonna go outside and pretend to use my cell phone.
Go.
Don't stay up all night.
No, there are not.
Thanks so much. I'll call you.
Wait, I thought you had a good time.
Oh, I did. I loved it. I've never been before.
Well, maybe I could come up.
Oh, Brian, you're so sweet. Really. But if I was gonna fuck you, you'd know. Thanks so much.
Send her in. It's quite rare for a president's chief of staff to climb the hill. A gesture of respect, no doubt, or desperation. I'm guessing she'll say Donald Blythe for education. Let's see if I'm right. Good morning, Linda. Thank you so much for making the trip up.
Of course, my pleasure.
Education.
First things first, the seating chart for the inauguration. How did these two work for you and Claire?
Wow.
They come with a complimentary set of tickets to the Jefferson Bowl.
Claire will be over the moon.
Good, I'm so glad. So, education. We have Donald Blythe drafting the legislation.
Donald Blythe? Jesus.
I know.
So you want a bill just two steps left of Karl Marx?
I advised the president-elect against it, but Donald is the face of education. He's been pushing reform for 25 years.
You want me to guide him to the middle?
We need a bill we can pass.
Do I have absolute autonomy and authority on this?
There's more. Garrett wants the bill on the floor in the first 100 days. He wants to make a pledge in his inaugural address.
Oh, that's very ambitious, Linda.
Can we make that pledge?
100 days? I can deliver.
Keep me posted.
I'll talk with Donald. I'll check in with you later in the week.
Terrific.
Did you smell that? The smugness, the false deference. She thinks I can be bought with a pair of tickets. What am I, a whore in post-war Berlin, salivating over free stockings and chocolate? What she's asking will cost far more than that.
Ferguson.
Too old.
Willis.
Too stupid.
Boyd.
Too queer.
Really? He's married with 3 kids.
And wouldn't they be devastated?
What about Catherine Durant?
Kathy Durant? She was vocally anti-Walker.
She's got the experience.
Set up a meeting.
Hey. The donation from Sancorp.
Mm-hmm.
The money will have to come from somewhere else.
God, what happened?
I've looked over the budget for fiscal 13, and we've allocated $1.6 million for salaries. We need to cut that in half.
You're suggesting...
Evelyn, we're going to let some people go.
That would be half of our staff.
We have to carve out some room. But you would have to fire some essential people who've been with us since the beginning.
We are a charity, but not for our employees.
You know, Claire, I have held my tongue about this whole international thing for a while, but I don't get it. I mean, we are really good at what we do. Why do we have to try and be something we're not?
Because we've plateaued, Evelyn, and it is time for us, for our entire organization.
But digging wells in Africa? We don't know anything about that.
Which is why we have to bring in new people. This is the plan that I've proposed to the board, and we are moving forward with it. I'd like a list of names, please.
Claire, can we just think about this?
I have thought about it. I've put a lot of thought into it.
Yeah, but I think Evelyn can really...
You're the office manager. I need you to trust that I know what I'm doing. So please get me that list as soon as possible.
I'm sorry, I just have one question.
Sir, I apologize. This woman...
Congressman.
Miss, you need to step away from me.
If I could just have one
step
second.
Away from the...
Who are you?
My name is Zoe Barnes. I'm a reporter at the Washington Herald.
It is after 10:30 at night, and this is my home. I do not allow
We're
any...
We're part of a mutual admiration society.
You're a fan of the symphony.
Well, more for the people watching than the music.
It's all right, Steve. Come on in, Miss Barnes.
It's strong.
You prefer it weak?
No. The stronger, the better. There's no harm in looking.
It's a cheap ploy.
It's cheap but effective.
Well, you certainly have my undivided attention.
Good. The reason I'm here...
Oh, is foreplay over?
I read somewhere that JFK never lasted more than 3 minutes.
The point being?
Time is precious. Powerful people don't have the luxury of foreplay.
Okay, so why are you here, Miss Bonds?
I need somebody I can talk to.
We're talking. Tell me what we're talking about.
I protect your identity. I print whatever you tell me, and I'll never ask any questions.
And what makes you think I don't already have such an arrangement with one of your colleagues?
Because if you did, you wouldn't have let me through the door.
I've led a very long, very successful career avoiding this sort of intrigue with the press. I can't see any advantage in starting now.
But is there any disadvantage?
Sloppiness, for one.
I promise you, absolute discretion.
So we're talking about trust.
Use whatever word you like.
Words matter very much, Miss Bonds. You should care more about them, given your profession.
Then yes, your trust.
So which Zoe Barnes am I to trust? The one who wrote about the fireman that married the meter maid? Or the one who authored a very fine article on a new jogging path in Rock Creek Park? Don't be flattered, I read everything.
I'm better than what they have me doing. You know what that feels like.
Do I?
You'd have made a great Secretary of State.
How exactly may I help you, Miss Bonds?
You must know the administration's legislative agenda. What's coming up first?
I may.
Will you tell me?
What would be your guess?
Education.
Why?
Immigration is too controversial. Tax reform isn't sexy enough. Everyone can get behind children. Is it education?
You might very well think that. I couldn't possibly comment.
A hint.
It's late, Miss Barnes.
Can we talk again?
I hope you'll understand that I want to sleep on all this. I never make such big decisions so long after sunset and so far from dawn.
My cell phone's on the back.
Do you put Miss Barnes in the visitor's ledger?
I am.
Don't. Needless to say.
Needless.
Hello.
Claire. This is Miss Zoe Barnes of the Washington Herald. She was just leaving.
Very nice to meet you, Mrs. Underwood. Drive safe. There's a lot of ice on the road.
I will. Thank you. Does that work on anybody?
Does what?
The push-up bra and the V-neck tee.
Well, if it does, I don't know who they are.
License and registration.
The glove compartment, sweetheart.
This isn't your driver's license. It's a Starbucks card. Sir, have you been drinking?
No, I never drink coffee at this hour.
I'm going to need you to step out of the car.
Hey, if I was speeding, you can write me a ticket.
Sir, step out of the car. Right now.
Look, I don't want to be a prick, but I'm a member of Congress.
I don't care if you're the king of China.
China doesn't have a king. It's a communist oligarchy.
Let's go. Out. You too, sweetie.
What is hard to say?
You've been police commissioner for what? Almost a decade now.
We're here to talk about my resume.
Mayor of D.C. would look good on that resume, wouldn't it? We know that you've been angling to run for some time. Experience is your strong suit. Endorsement and fundraising, they're not. We can help with that.
Russo, they're free to go.
It was just a few drinks.
It was enough to get pulled over.
I wasn't drunk.
Were you alone?
Yes.
Say it to my face.
I wasn't wrong.
Say it to my face.
Yes, I was alone.
You cannot keep doing this, Peter. It's going to catch up with you. Do you think we can arrange two more at our table for the Jefferson Ball?
Whom?
The Holborns.
Why on earth would you want them there?
I'm going to need her money for the CWI. The staff cuts are just not enough.
I'll talk to Vasquez.
How are we doing?
Good. Progress. Irons in the fire.
I like irons, but I love fire.
Garbage, Donald. Tax increases, ban on vouchers, federal oversight. How do you expect me to get that through?
Linda told me to write it. She promised
I'm
that.
I'm sure she said any number of things. Forget what they promised you, Donald. They want your name because it carries weight.
Well, my name comes with my ideas.
I understand, but you've got to be reasonable. This isn't the great debate. It's about passing meaningful reform. Maybe not everything you would have hoped, but help me help you.
That's going to take time. Those ideas I've been developing.
If it's time you need, I will buy you time. You've got to promise me your next at bat is going to give me something I can work with.
Okay, Frank. I'll see what I can do.
Good. And Donald, don't let this get you down. Why, together we're going to do more than you've been able to do in 25 years. Two things are now irrelevant. Donald Blythe and Donald Blythe's new draft. Eventually, I'll have to rewrite the bill myself. Forward, that is the battle cry. Leave ideology to the armchair generals. Does me no good.
Walker just nominated Kern.
It's a long road to confirmation.
Kern is a Boy Scout.
Nobody's a Boy Scout, not even Boy Scouts.
What do you have?
Absolutely nothing.
Then what are we talking about?
Just asking a simple question. Does the job interest you?
Why would you want Michael gone?
Kathy, you and I came up together. The Foreign Affairs Committee needs a secretary we can work with. Someone who isn't afraid to stand up to Walker when he's wrong. We need you.
Let's assume I am interested.
I don't want to assume. I want to know.
Zoe Barnes. Anywhere you want. On my way. I'm gonna have to call you back. So sorry. I couldn't get a cab. I had to take a train.
Just before you left my house. Think back. What were we discussing?
The president's legislative agenda.
Specifically.
Education. Was I right?
Do the math, Miss Barnes.
He's a bill.
Sponsored by?
You?
Be smarter than that.
Somebody with legitimacy.
Good. And who screams legitimacy in education?
Donald Blythe?
Correct. The problem is...
He's an old-school tax and spend liberal. Walker ran as a moderate. You think Blythe would talk to me?
He doesn't have to.
Wait, we're in a very gray area, ethically, legally, which I'm okay with.
I just love this painting, don't you? We're in the same boat now, Zoe. Take care not to tip it over. I can only save one of us from drowning.
He announces his education initiative on Monday. Half of the address is based on...
I understand.
Do we need to take it out?
We're fine, Linda.
But you just got through saying he has to start over.
I didn't choose Blythe. You did. You put him in my lap and asked me to work a miracle, and I will. Now, have a little faith, Linda. Let me work with Donald on this. I know what can be accomplished in 100 days.
All right, Frank. We're counting on you.
Good. Now, I do have a little favor to ask. Do you think I can get just 2 more tickets for my table at the Jefferson Ball? Drink?
Sure. What do you got?
Whiskey. Blend.
If you're offering.
So, how are things in the city of brotherly love?
We're getting by.
Good. 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 Oh, I'm sorry. I made that neat. Did you want it? It's perfect. So, it seems you've been a bit irresponsible.
What?
Don't play dumb with me, Peter. Save it for the ethics committee. Drink up. You could use a little courage right now.
You're not having one.
It's a bit early in the day for me.
Is this about the other night? How do you know about that?
I'm the whip. It's my job to know.
Look, they let me off. There's no charges. It's all taken care of.
Honestly, Peter, do you really think these things just take care of themselves?
It was just this one time, Frank. I swear to God.
Then you must hold God in very low esteem, because we both know that's a lie. Solicitation, controlled substances, driving under the influence. Got quite a long list of hobbies.
What is it you want?
Your absolute, unquestioning loyalty.
Always.
Do not misunderstand what I mean by loyalty.
Anything. Name it, Frank.
You seem far too relaxed.
I'm not.
You shouldn't be. Doug will be in touch.
You seem far too relaxed. You shouldn't be.
Where have you been?
Alex will be in touch.
I've been calling you. Everybody's working double time without your ration. You just up and disappeared. Hang on. Let me call you back. Where did you get this?
Wrong question. The right question is, how quickly can we get it up on the site?
I have to run this fast, Tom. Let's get legal on this. Make sure we're not breaking any laws. You won't tell me a source?
I can't do that.
Fine. But if legal finds even one...
I understand. How long do you think that will take? We should get this online right away.
I'm not just going to scan a 300-page document and put it up before we have gone through everything.
I did that already.
The whole thing?
Cover to cover. I've got excerpts, analysis, 3,000 words ready for editing.
You start going over that. Get graphics working on tables, charts, the whole nine yards. Janine! What's the angle? Five words.
Far left of center.
That's four.
Very far left of center.
Enough to put Walker on his heels?
Fuck his heels, this will put him on his ass.
What's up?
We've got a copy of the administration's education bill. You're going to work with Zoe and do background cover.
Zoe Barnes? Right here.
Whatever she needs.
But shouldn't I be writing
She wrote it already, and I want you to rewrite it. Then rewrite it again. You'll help her.
Tom, I am your chief political correspondent.
Go. I want this by tomorrow.
But I need to focus on the inauguration.
This is more important.
Let's get started.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States. That I will faithfully execute the office...
Power is a lot like real estate. It's all about location, location, location. The closer you are to the source, the higher your property value. Centuries from now, when people watch this footage, who will they see smiling just at the edge of the frame?
So help me God. Congratulations.
Today is not about the next 4 years. It's about the next four decades. Now, you've placed your faith in me, and I, in turn, choose to place that faith in our children. Our children are the key to this nation's future. And that's why the first order of business for this administration will be a comprehensive education reform bill to properly fix, finance, and strengthen our nation's schools. And I pledge to you, we will have that bill on the floor of the Congress within the first 100 days of this administration.
It was so nice of you to make this possible. When you called me, I was a moon.
I'm going to miss out on my ultimate frisbee league this season. No, I'm serious. A few of us on budget have quite a rivalry going with the guys on finance. It's fierce. We get physical. Anybody gets between me and that goal line, I will take that sucker down.
Looking for you everywhere, Maestro.
Yeah, let me help you out. I really like the work you've done on the new draft. It's a big step forward. We're going to make history.
Thanks for your encouragement, Francis. Listen, I've got some ideas about subsidies.
Yeah,
hold on to that thought, Donald. Don't you look stumped.
We Southern girls clean up well when we get out of our Daisy Dukes and into some Vera White.
And we Southern boys are slow with our words, but we're fast on our feet. May I have the honor?
You most certainly may.
House tricks.
I can't kick. Wanna go on in?
No, why don't you set me up outside?
Outside? It's freezing out here.
Well, a little cold never hurt anybody.
Anything you say, Frank. It'll be right up.
My one guilty pleasure is a good rack of ribs, even at 7:30 in the morning. I have the whole place to myself. Freddie sometimes opens up just for me. Where I come from in South Carolina, people didn't have two pennies to rub together. A rack of ribs is a luxury. Like Christmas in July.
previously on House of Cards. Power is a lot like real estate. It's all about location, location, location. Centuries from now, when people watch this footage, who will they see smiling just at the edge of the frame?
We are not nominating you for Secretary of State.
If not me, then who?
Michael Kern.
Michael Kern? Well, that is an excellent choice. I know what I have to do. However we do this, we'll also need a buffer.
You mean an errand boy?
Yes, someone we control completely. Solicitation, controlled substances, driving under the influence. Got quite a long list of hobbies. What is it you want? Your absolute loyalty.
The money will have to come from somewhere else. You suggest, Evelyn, we're going to let some people go.
This is the Washington Herald, Zoe. It's not TMZ.
Which is why print journalism is dying. We're part of a mutual admiration society. Does that work on anybody?
Does what?
The push-up bra and V-neck tee.
Well, you certainly have my undivided attention.
I protect your identity. I print whatever you tell me, and I'll never ask any questions.
You just up and disappeared.
Where did you get this?
Wrong question.
Enough to walk on his heels?
Fuck his heels, just to put him on his ass.
Christmas in July. You know what I like about people? They stack so well.
Let me get this for you. What, babe?
No.
This is too much.
Not half enough. Thanks for opening up for me.
Any time, day or night, you know that.
In a town where everyone's so carefully reinventing themselves, what I like about Freddy is that he doesn't even pretend to change. Oh, I'm late. Every Tuesday, I sit down with the Speaker and the Majority Leader to discuss the week's agenda. Well, discuss is probably the wrong word. They talk while I sit quietly and imagine their lightly salted faces frying in a skillet.
Shitting herself. Shitting herself, or Walker shitting himself and shoveling his shit on her shit.
Bob, I'm planning on eating.
Do we have a backup on the docket?
You're on that, right, Frank?
Yeah, I'm working with my staff. The Republicans are going to ram this up our ass. I would if I was there.
Well, even if we squeak it through the House, watch them mangle it in the Senate.
Or filibuster.
Well, sure, if it looks anything like this.
I don't know why Walker's trying to tackle a charging elephant. It's madness.
Congressman, sorry to interrupt. I saw you sitting over here.
Remy. Gentlemen, this is Remy Denton. Remy, this is Speaker Birch.
I'm well aware, Mr. Speaker, Congressman.
Remy just made partner at Glendon Hill.
Glendon Hill? Great team over there. Congratulations.
Thank you.
When was the last time they added a partner?
It's been a while.
Well, they know a winner when they see one. Remy was the best press secretary I ever had.
Why'd you let him go?
I didn't. They stole him away.
What accounts do you have?
Sancorp Industries is my main one. I run that account now. Anyhow, I'll let you get back to it. Sorry again to interrupt.
No problem.
Very nice to meet you both.
Christ, the lobbyists keep getting younger and younger.
He's probably making more than all of us combined.
Gentlemen, this one's on me. I'm going to track down that check.
Glendon Hill fronts Sancorp Industries. Sancorp is deep into natural gas. I don't give a hoot about natural gas, but I have 67 deputy whips, and they all need cash to win races. Sancorp helps me purchase loyalty, and in return, they expect mine. It's degrading, I know, but when the tit's that big, everybody gets in line. Tell them I'm on top of it.
I need more than that.
You are well aware that I do not drop the ball on things like this, Remy.
Promises, friend. Secretary of State, Argentina, the offshore drilling contract.
Talk to me when I've solved the problem. Don't waste my time when I'm working on solving.
When there's billions on the line, you can't not call me back, and I can't not show up.
Fine. Thank you for your diligence.
Eight figures to you in the DCCC. $6 million to build that library of yours in your name.
I know.
Don't make them throw money at your challenger next cycle.
You've made your point.
Have I? I hope so.
It's such a waste of talent. He chose money over power. In this town, a mistake nearly everyone makes. Money is the McMansion in Sarasota that starts falling apart after 10 years. Power is the old stone building that stands for centuries. I cannot respect someone who doesn't see the difference.
What am I looking at?
The Williams Register.
Williams?
College, September 78.
And why am I looking at it?
The editorial.
Not that interesting.
Michael Kern went to Williams. Check out the masthead. And then there's this.
It's thin.
The guy's a unicorn. He pisses rainbows.
You think we can get traction with this?
I think you could.
Linda Vasquez is on the phone.
I'm surprised it took her this long.
It's only 9:06.
Which means she read the Herald 3 hours ago and spent the past 2.5 getting reamed by the president. Tell her I'm on my way.
You were supposed to keep Donald in line. You assured me that you...
25 years he's been pushing this particular agenda. We got between the mother bear and her cub. It's a setback, that's all.
On our first day in office.
Linda, I've worked with 4 presidents. Setbacks are a dime a dozen with Bill of this size.
Frank, if you can't control this...
I don't take well to being micromanaged, Linda. You want to do my job for me and run the White House? Good luck. I won't stand in your way.
Okay, Frank. Fine. This is yours now. If this thing can't make it to the floor in the first 100 days, then I'll let you explain to the president why he lied to the American people.
I'm gonna get back to work.
Please do.
Should be doing this on a Friday and instead of a Wednesday. Because if we do it on a Friday, people have the weekend.
Fine, we'll do it on Friday. Is all the paperwork ready?
Some of the more senior people are trickier. There's severance.
But we shouldn't run into any legal issues.
No. We use at-will employment contracts across the board.
We'll get started first thing Friday. I want all of the exit interviews done by lunch.
I just can't help but think that this is a mistake.
We've discussed this already.
I know, but I just have to say it for the sake of my conscience. I think that you are dismantling what we have built over the past 10 years, and I... And I think the way you're handling this is cruel.
It's not easy, Evelyn. But it's necessary.
You have always asked me to be honest with you. It's how we work together. I disagree with something, I say it. Well, I disagree 100%. Please, Claire, don't do this.
I respect your opinion, Evelyn, and I appreciate you sharing it with me, but I'm not going to change my mind. Friday, then.
That's what you want?
Now, this is major reform, like a complete overhaul.
That would usually take months.
Well, we only have days, not months.
Oh, but think about the process. I mean, we can't
when
just...
When I asked my colleagues, your bosses, who are the smartest minds in education, out of hundreds, we arrived at you. The 6 of you in this room. Now, I realize it is a difficult task, but we have the opportunity to make history here. And I want all of us to make it together. So good luck. We're counting on you.
Page one. These bullet points reflect the key planks at the center of our bill. Get comfy. This is your home until we have a presentable first draft.
Donald, what a morning.
I have no idea how they got this. I specifically told my staff to destroy everything, and I can't imagine...
It doesn't matter how it happened. We can't make it unhappen, so now we have to adapt.
Don't they realize that this is a first draft? All we have here really is a perception problem.
We don't get a second chance at a first impression, Donald. You know that. Now, look, I'm on your side, but Linda is furious.
What's she saying?
They want to point fingers.
At me?
I told her we cannot do that. I mean, you are vital to this process. I'm up to here with them, Donald. For lying, for turning their back on you. You know, I'm of a mind to say, screw it. I'll fall on this grenade myself just to piss them off. Give me John King at CNN.
Wait, Frank, this is not your fault.
No, we have to protect your reputation.
No, but you're the man that needs to get the bill through the House.
I will, hang on. I will assign it to one of my deputies and quietly manage it, and I'll help guide you through the process.
I am not comfortable with this.
Well, then what do you suggest we do? What a martyr craves more than anything is a sword to fall on. So you sharpen the blade, hold it at just the right angle, and then 3, 2, 1.
It should be me. It was my bill.
No, impossible. Donald, look, education has been your life's work.
The truth is, my heart is not in this fight. You know me. I'm not a wheeler dealer. I could put my mind to policy, but I'm no good at this brand of politics.
Well, if not you, then who?
It should be you, Frank. You're formidable. People respect you. They will follow your lead. Let me be on the sidelines for this.
Well, I could only consider that as an option if I knew that I could still come to you for counsel.
Of course. Whatever you need. Part of me is glad this got leaked. Well, it would have been better if it hadn't, but at least people know where I stand.
Thank you, Don.
Happy to do it, Frank.
He has no idea we got 6 kids in the next room already working on a new draft.
Stamper!
But why dampen his mood by telling him? We just gave him a great gift, the chance to fulfill his destiny. Write up a statement for Blythe, stepping aside, fresh ideas, etc., etc. Make it dignified, he's a good man. Oh, and bring me that Williams editorial.
After careful thought and discussion with my staff, I am relinquishing my management of the Education Reform Act. I hope to remain a part of the process, but I won't be working...
Why did you leak the draft?
I'm not exactly sure how it got leaked, but it does represent...
It came from your office, though, Frank.
We wrote it, but I don't...
Who'll be managing the bill now?
Frank Underwood.
Was that your choice, or did the administration...
I feel very confident placing the bill in Frank's capable hands.
Deep throat of you.
Well, I can't help you dispatch a president. How about a senator? The editorial on the Camp David Accords. It is the opinion of this newspaper that President Carter demand Israel withdraw all its citizens from the Gaza Strip and West Bank.
Which it has illegally occupied since 1967.
Illegally occupied? That's quite an incendiary quote, don't you think? For an administration that says the Middle East is its top foreign policy priority.
Michael Kern? Did he personally write the editorial?
He was the editor.
But did he write it himself? Then there's no story.
I'm saying it's a question worth asking.
And if he denies involvement?
He will. Let him.
This is a man trying to be confirmed as Secretary of State. Everything is a story.
There's no direct link. I can't get this past Hammerschmidt.
Remember this moment when you resisted me. When you said the words, then there is no story. Get a good night's sleep, Miss Bond.
We have a big day tomorrow.
The basement is mine.
I know. It's not for me.
So who's it for?
For you.
There's a gym in the Capitol.
Which you never use.
Because I'm a tad busy running the country.
But not at home. So now you have no excuse.
I want it out.
Give it a try first.
Is this your subtle way of saying that I'm out of shape?
No, it's my way of suggesting you could be in better shape.
That sounds both passive-aggressive and condescending.
Just plain aggressive and true. Don't wait up for me.
Are you going running now?
Yes, because I couldn't this morning. I had an early meeting.
Use the monstrosity. It's freezing out.
You break it.
It looks positively medieval, doesn't it? I'm trying to turn my only sanctuary into a fitness dungeon. I won't have it.
It's a stretch.
We're not misleading anyone. He was the editor.
Did you call for comment?
I tried three times. The press secretary said, get back to me. He didn't.
What about research? You couldn't find anything to echo the editorial? No quotes? No op-ed pieces?
Don't you think if something like that existed, someone would have printed it by now? Nobody else has this, Lucas.
I don't think there's a story here.
I'm not saying there's a story. All I'm saying is that there's a question that needs to be answered. This is a nominee for Secretary of State. We have an editorial on Palestine and Israel.
Which he didn't write.
Which we don't know he didn't write.
Exactly.
We don't have to print it. I could just scan the thing, stick it on a site, and tweet the link. But if I did that, some other paper might...
Whoa. Don't be a bitch. I'll talk to Tom.
That's all I was asking.
We simply can't afford to allow the...
We got a guy. He's almost perfect. He's a libertarian drug fiend marinating in a mobile home.
I didn't agree with President Reagan on many things, but there was some merit to the notion of trickle-down economics, and I feel there is much merit to the idea of trickle-down diplomacy. If we...
Those are my lines. Vasquez must have given them to him.
...stalemate between Israel and Palestine, that success will trickle down to 100 other diplomatic dilemmas between Muslims, Jews, Christians...
I'm glad you brought up Israel and Palestine, because just before we came on the air, I received an advance copy of an article that's going to be in tomorrow's Washington Herald's front page, and it was written by Zoe Barnes. And in it, she quotes an editorial that ran in the Williams College Register when you were editor back in September 1978, which called the Israeli presence in the Gaza Strip and West Bank, quote, an illegal occupation.
Can I see that?
Sure. Did you write those words, illegal occupation?
No. I have no memory of this.
You were the editor of the paper.
Yes. But
so it couldn't have gone out without your approval?
No, of course not. But my staff, somebody else usually wrote the and then we'd vote. And
well,
most
did
of us
vote
felt
for it?
That, honestly, George, I can't remember. It was 35 years
so
ago.
You're not sure whether or not
look,
you supported these words?
I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt, I did not write these words.
But were they in line with your thinking at the time?
This is ludicrous.
That's all I need. Him laughing.
I understand that.
Nancy, give me Dennis Mendel at the ADL.
State. The Middle
yes.
East is a vital American interest.
Yes.
What you think about the Middle East is relevant.
You can look at my voting record. Every single vote has been in defense of
so
Israel.
So when did your views
right.
change?
What I'm saying to you is what's important now, George, is how I have voted while I have represented the great state of Colorado.
I understand that's your position, but a lot of other people are going to look at it and think what you thought then is relevant as well.
Let me ask you this. Have you ever changed your views since college?
Certainly, but I'm not the nominee for Secretary of State.
Even if I did have it's this gone. Viewpoint, this has not been my
it's
viewpoint
a
since I have been
in. What were you saying when you came in?
I found a guy who was on the college editorial staff when Kern was there.
This burnout, still pumping mimeograph manifestos out of a trailer park in the Berkshires.
Well, you're not planning on talking to him.
Peter Russo.
Good. Sounds like a perfect match. Dennis. Any chance you're watching Stephanopoulos? You look sexy when you're improving the lives of hard-working Pennsylvanians.
Is it the improving lives or is it these fetching sweatpants?
Why don't you move that computer out of the way? Let me see what that looks like. Yeah, it's better with the laptop.
Fuck off.
You're not paying enough attention to me.
I pay attention to you all day at the office. Hey, you know, I don't think I've ever seen you brush your teeth before.
Sure you have.
No, I don't think so. I mean, I know that you do brush, but I don't think I've ever actually witnessed it before.
Well, here it is in all its glory.
Is that my toothbrush?
I don't know. Is it?
Yes, it is.
You left it here.
Peter, gross.
Oh, come on. We've exchanged plenty of fluids by now.
Oh. No. No, toothpaste.
It's not toothpaste. I'm a rabbit.
No. Go get it.
I have to take this.
Mrs. Russo.
Yeah, right now it's 12:53.
Is everything okay?
It's work stuff.
What kind of work stuff?
Congressman Walensky. He wants to go over the tax incentive stuff we sent him.
Peter, it's 1 a.m. Hey, Peter.
I have meetings tomorrow. I have a committee hearing. The Congress will survive without you. Address, directions. There's a neat ticket in your name. Your flight leaves at 6:30. You should head to the airport.
This is coming from Frank.
No. This is coming from no one. You have the flu and you're calling in sick. What's that?
It's what?
Is that a hickey? Are you whoring around again?
No, I have a girlfriend.
You mean your little office romance?
What do you know about that?
When it comes to your life, Peter, and what I know about it, you should assume that there's no such thing as a secret. Stay in touch. You call me on my cell, never at the office. Good luck. Knock him dead, Tiger.
Tired, under-caffeinated, but we're making progress.
Less than a week to go.
Yeah, we'll do our best.
You what?
We'll get it done.
Let somebody open a window. It's rancid in here.
That is what happens when 6 people don't shower for half a week.
Anything you need other than deodorant?
Yeah, this performance standards thing. The teachers' unions are gonna...
Leave it in.
But we could deliver...
I'll handle the unions. What else? Anything?
Conjugal visits. We'll get back to work.
Nancy! What do I have next?
Constituent calls from 210 to 235, fundraising until 350, deputy caucus at 4.
The call list?
It's on your desk.
My briefing for the caucus?
Next to the call list.
Have you been in the conference room? Have it steam cleaned over the weekend. In the meantime, get those poor kids some Febreze or something. It's like a petting zoo. You gotta see this.
But were they in line with your thinking at the time?
We do not consider the issue of Israel and Palestine a laughing matter. And he calls Israel illegal. While he's an anti-Semite and he is wrong, we would have grave, grave concerns about appointing such a man our next Secretary of State.
It's too easy. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Peter Russo. Congressman Russo. I'd like to just speak to you for just a second. Sir?
Either you're lying and you can fuck off, or you're telling the truth and you can absolutely fuck off.
I saw your website. I'm a fan. And I brought you something.
Hey, babe, put some clothes on.
What?
We got a guest.
So? Hey.
Oh, put some clothes on. Ice or no ice?
I have no ice.
Good. We don't have any.
Oh, fuck.
Echo, I told you to put the...
Okay, okay. I'll keep your secret if you keep mine.
A congressman, you say?
Right now, I'm just a drinking companion.
Well, all right, companion. Have yourself a drink.
But I don't know if I'm the girl you're looking for.
You're definitely the girl that I'm looking for.
Excuse me.
All I want for that money is your silence.
The what?
The guy you were with the other night. The one who was arrested. Do you know who he was?
You mean the congressman?
There was no congressman. There was no arrest. None of that exists. All that exists is the money sitting right there in front of you. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Good. Open your mouth.
Used it.
How do you know I haven't?
Francis.
You know I don't like to be managed.
I'm not trying to manage you. I just don't want to outlive you by 25 years.
I must walk 3 miles a day around that Capitol. I'm constantly on my feet. And do you know how many calories the brain burns?
I'm not worried about your brain. It's your heart we're talking about. Use the machine.
She's right. I should take better care of myself. But it's the principle. I won't be a slave to anybody or anything you can order with a toll-free number.
We share the wealth in this republic.
I thought the whole editorial team pitched in.
Sometimes. Not that time, though.
But he must have written some of it.
Oh, that was all me.
What if people thought he wrote it?
Oh, fuck that. He's a fraud. Nah, he's worse than a fraud. He's a fucking farce. I'll tell you something. He used to be even more of a maniac than I am.
Chemicals?
No, politics. No, we had some nights, man. Long conversations. Dangerous fucking notions.
Like what?
Like, you name it. OPEC, Pinochet, the fucking Food Stamp Act, and the motherland sang her mating call. Oh, say, can you? Next thing, he's cramming for the bar at Bryn Mawr and snapping on a flag pin.
Does Bryn Mawr have a lawsuit?
No, my point is, he started goose-stepping in the marionette parade. Left, right, red, blue, Democrat, Republican. They're all dangling from the same strings. Take a sledgehammer to the whole fucking Punch and Judy show. That's what's required.
I thought you were a patriot.
Fuck yeah, one of the few.
So what's wrong with public service?
Public service? Come on, man. You gotta get a grip on who your masters are. The IMF, the World Bank, the Rockefeller Trilateral Commission. You bankroll their fucking death squads. It's called FEMA. It's called Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. NATO, Border Control. You think Katrina was incompetence? That was highly orchestrated negligence. Look at Waco, Amnesty International, the ACLU, smokescreens, all of them, blood on their hands.
Well, exactly.
You want me to lie to the people.
I want you to spare the people another hypocrite.
What's in it for you?
Poetic justice?
Oh, come on. You're one of them.
Can a corporate sellout roll a joint like this?
If I wanted to do this thing, how might I go about that precisely?
There were a few tears here and there, and some anger, but nothing unexpected.
I'm going to need you to leave us today, too, Evelyn. I'm sorry. I just can't have any doubt about the direction I'm taking.
You just had me fire 18 people.
I know.
I sat across from them in this room, and I had to tell each and every one.
I know.
I am 59 years old. Nobody hires anybody my age.
I will write you any kind of
record. To do what?
Back groceries.
What am I supposed to tell
you? I'm sorry, Evelyn. I
do. No, you're not. You don't give a fuck. 18 people, Claire. 19, if you count me. I have to call my
today has been tough. A lot of your colleagues have left, and I owe you an explanation. Many of those who left us today helped build the CWI from the ground up. I'm grateful to them. But it is time for us to evolve. And to accomplish this, we had to make hard choices and bring in new people. That's what today was about. You have any questions? My door is always open.
I'm all good for National and Metro. We've got space for political if we need it.
Janine, anything new on Michael Kern?
The White House is dodging.
You can't get anyone on record.
Not just me. They're shutting all of us down in the briefings. No one is giving an inch, even on background. In the meantime, I'm working on a feature about the administration's foreign policy agenda, how it shifted from the start of the campaign, increased DOD spending,
and... I see you, Zoe.
I can link Kern directly to the Williams editorial.
What?
I've got a guy named Roy Kopeniak who was on the editorial staff when Kern was there.
Twitter twat. WTF.
Wait.
Roy what?
Kopeniak, a classmate of Kern's. I have him on record saying Kern wrote every word of the editorial.
Let's move this into my office. Zoe, Lucas. Janine!
Let me once and for all say this definitively. I didn't author that editorial. Not a single sentence, word, comma, or period. If memory serves me, it was Mr. Kopeniak who wrote it. Why on earth he's trying to claim that I did is beyond me. Let me further say that I'm a strong supporter of the state of Israel. As the most stable country in the region and our strongest...
It's Frank Underwood for Kathy.
In any peace process, because without the stability of Israel, there can be no Palestine.
CNN right now.
Without Israel, there can be no Palestine.
I've got it all.
I would remind Senator Kern that there was a Palestine long before there was an Israel. His comments are not only ignorant, they are racist.
Get ready, Kathy. Things are about to move very quickly.
Understanding of the Middle East.
Okay.
Is so out of
I'm ready.
Hey.
Yeah.
Not yet. Oh, not
stop.
Now.
Hey, where have you been?
God, you're fucking high.
No,
Yes, you are. Look at your eyes.
Oh, please, just lay off.
You promised me it wouldn't be like this.
Cancel whatever I have for the rest of the day. Technically, he'll withdraw himself, but yes.
Can I say a source close to the White House?
No, you let this story play out in its own time. They'll announce in the morning.
I'm sorry, if not that, what story are we talking about?
Catherine Durant. As soon as Kern withdraws, you say she'll be the replacement.
Is that true?
It will be after you write it.
Roy Kopeniak was you.
You might very well think that. I couldn't possibly comment.
You found him. You have a
plan. Kopeniak and Kern were appetizers, Miss Barnes. Catherine Durant is the meal. Say that name. Catherine Durant. Say it over and over. Tomorrow afternoon, write it down. Then watch that name come out of the mouth of the President of the United States. This is where we get to create. Miss your train, Miss Barnes. It's the last one tonight.
Zoe Barnes of the Washington Herald now reporting, quoting a source close to the president, as saying that Senator Catherine Durant will likely be the new nominee for Secretary of State after Michael Curran's withdrawal earlier this week.
The White House has remained silent on whether the president will tap Durant for the nomination, but a national Zogby poll shows wide support for Durant across the red line.
Has served 10 years on the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, made numerous diplomatic missions to South America.
We can place our faith in her, knowing that we have a responsible, experienced, brilliant woman representing our interests abroad.
Middle of the road, team player, strong in defense, and if there's a woman that can work with the Joint Chiefs, she's the one.
Durant is the way to go. It's a no-brainer. The president should stop.
Why are we still talking about if they're going to nominate Durant? Why don't they just do it already so we can all stop talking about ifs and start talking about when and what and how Durant's going to shape a foreign policy? How are we going to do it?
History?
History.
I'm very impressed, Frank.
Good. With your go-ahead, I'll start the markup.
Have Birch and Rasmussen seen this?
Not yet. I wanted you to be the first to have a look.
I'll schedule a time for you to fill in the president.
Oh, no, no, no. That is your turf, Linda. You should do that.
Thank you, Frank.
My pleasure. Thank you.
I so apologize for everything.
No. It's not necessary. Now for the real meeting. So what is happening with Michael Kern?
A total nightmare.
You know who you're going to tap next?
Frank, we still need you in the house.
No, I wouldn't dream of it. We've got our education bill. I was just curious.
Somehow, the rumor is flying around that we're going to nominate Catherine Durant. I'm sure you've noticed.
Is the rumor true?
Well, we weren't considering her at first, but the president asked me to have her vetted in case we want to go that route.
Interesting.
What do you think?
Well, she wouldn't be my first choice.
Who would be your first choice?
She campaigned hard against us in the primaries.
That's my reservation.
But you'd show yourself above party politics, and I know she'd work all the harder for it. Decent experience, respect across the aisle.
So you think we can seriously consider her?
It's not the worst idea in the world.
Getting this shit.
What?
Your stories.
I was
Who
just...
are you fucking?
Nobody.
Oh, come on. You're a metro scrub, and now look at you. You'd have to be fucking somebody important.
I'm just doing my job, Janine. Excuse me.
First remote?
Yeah, it's my first time.
Right into the camera. Don't shift in your seat. And there's no reason to speak above a conversational volume that Michael will pick you up. Y'all ready?
Yeah.
All right, don't forget to breathe.
Very glad to be here. Thank you for having me.
You wrote the education bill, current editorial
now to rain. I'm just thrilled to be reporting news that matters. And it's truly been a team effort. Everyone at the Herald pitched in. But yes, a lot of firsts. First national story, first.
Thank you. Calling it a night.
See you tomorrow, sir.
But yes, a lot of firsts. First national story, first front page byline, first TV interview. I would wave to my mom, but the cameraman said not to shift in my seat.
What a roller coaster. It really is too bad. Kern is a good man.
And now Catherine Durant.
Yes. Right place, right time, I suppose.
We like her, don't we?
Very much.
Question is, does she like Sancorp as much as we like her?
I would say that that is a very good bet. But then again, I'm not a betting man.
No, you always like a sure thing.
When it avails itself, good night, Remy.
Good night, Frank. See you around.
Hopefully less and less now.
Oh, no, I charged the wrong thing. What did you have again? Medium decaf latte. Red lot. Duck. I don't know how to get it to go back.
This one.
This one?
No, let me do it.
Oh.
ask you to stay back, Congressman.
What's going on?
Some guy was trying to get into the building. When we said no, he started tearing his clothes off.
Nobody can hear you. Nobody cares about you. Nothing will come of this. Why don't you let these nice gentlemen take you home?
Cover them up. It's cold out here.
You heard the congressman?
Previously on House of Cards.
That's why the first order of business, to properly fix
and strengthen our nation's schools.
We need a bill we can pass. The president wants the bill on the floor in the first 100 days.
Yeah, this performance standards thing. The teachers' union.
I'll handle the unions. What else? Anything?
Guard, you're fucking high.
No.
Yes, you are. Look at your eyes.
Oh, please, just lay off.
Is that true?
It will be after you, right?
I received an advance copy, and it was written by Zoe Barnes.
Zoe Barnes of the Washington Herald now reporting, quoting a source close to the president.
Who are you fucking?
What?
Oh, come on. You're a metro scrub, and now look at you.
Zoe, thank you for joining us.
I'm very glad to be here. Thank you for having me.
Evelyn, we're going to let some people go.
I think the way you're handling this is cruel.
I'm going to need you to leave us today, too, Evelyn. I'm sorry. I just can't have any doubt about the direction I'm taking.
Page 43, section 7. We'd like some clarification.
Section 7 has to do with the evaluative measures.
Evaluative measures. We're talking about here a performance standards, plain and simple.
We can't have that. We open that can of worms.
Gotta take it out.
The administration wants it
then
in.
Then we're all wasting our time.
Well, look, I can cut down the frequency of testing, but it's got
That's
to be part of the overall...
That's the thin edge of a two-ton wedge. No way. Non-debatable.
All right, hold on. There's no harm in hearing them out, right? Frank, what do you have in mind?
We adjust Article 4. Hand me Article 4. We go every 3 years instead of 2.
Frank, for us to even consider testing...
Marty, we can't negotiate time intervals here.
If, I'm just saying if, the frequency could never be more than 5
Look,
years.
Look, 5 is a little high, but if you could bend on that...
Marty!
Wait. And it's not just frequency. Veteran teachers would have to be exempt if they have a proven record of excellence with the students.
Well, excuse me for a moment. Corey, will you take the reins on?
Right. So, Article 4, in terms of exemptions...
I've been saying for years that we should tear it down. It's vulgar. It's an embarrassment to the county. But time and time again, Frank Underwood has fought to keep it standing. If it weren't for him, the Peachoid would have been replaced ages ago. And Jessica Masters would still be alive. The congressman needs to answer for this tragedy.
What exactly happened?
A 17-year-old girl ran off the road texting her boyfriend, and I quote, "Doesn't the Peachoid look like a giant?" And then she lost control of the car.
Jesus.
Warren's making a big fuss in the local press. And he's pushing the parents to sue Gaffney.
Sue Gaffney? It's in his own jurisdiction.
It's worth throwing Gaffney under the bus to drag you into the mess.
He's after my seat again. Has he learned absolutely nothing?
It's a full-on smear campaign, boss. He's out to destroy you.
With this, it's a peach, for Christ's sake. Let him make a fool out of himself.
No, he will make a fool out of you. If he spins this right, gets national coverage...
National coverage? It's a joke.
And you will be the butt of it. We can't afford that right now. Not when you're in the spotlight with the education bill.
This thing has caused me so much damn trouble.
I know.
So who should I call? Parents?
Phone call's not gonna cut it. You need to go down there.
Can it wait until Monday?
We get on this thing right now, we can contain it. We wait until Monday, then there's no way to know how much this is gonna blow up on
us. I can't go down to Gaffney. The unions have just...
We postpone.
They're gonna be livid.
Marty's reasonable, okay? He will explain to them.
And they're just supposed to understand and accept that I had to get up from the negotiating table because some two-bit county administrator wants
to... I don't want to interrupt you, sir, but this is not just about Orrin. It's about the parents. Now you think about the lawsuit. What happens if you have to testify? Subpoenas, depositions, you get dragged into a court battle, there is no education bill. We can't ignore this.
I just hate this small ball crap.
Thank you.
call the what? The peach what?
The peachoid.
It's a giant water tower in the shape of a peach.
Oh, wow. I just Googled it, the peachoid.
She was 17, Linda.
You're right. I'm sorry.
I need another week.
No, it's not going to work. The president makes a speech on Tuesday. We've already announced.
Speeches can be rescheduled.
We have to show some progress on education.
Frank, the first 100 days is almost over.
We push back the speech, it'll look like we're spinning our wheels.
All right, I'll work something out. Thank you, Linda.
Frank, these are the heads of the two largest teachers' unions in the country.
I understand.
They flew here in a weekend.
Doug will lead the charge. Congressman Phillips is well vetted.
They flew here to see you, Frank. You're managing this bill.
Put this in the other bag, and I'll be in constant communication. Anything big comes up, I'm a phone call away.
It's a 300-page document. We need you in that room.
I would stay if I could, but this is my home district. Now, Marty, cut me a little slack here. We'll get it done. You and I go way back. Have I ever let you down?
No, you haven't.
I don't intend to start now.
Hello?
To finally meet you.
I'm a little under the weather. I don't want to get you sick.
Well, if you're feeling ill...
No, I'm fine. It's just a cold.
Well, thank you for coming in.
Of course.
Shall we talk in my office?
These are really cool photographs.
Oh, thank you. Adam Galloway took the pictures. Have you heard of him?
No.
I met him at the Whitney Biennial a couple of years ago and commissioned him to do these. He just had a big show at PS1.
I'm not up to date on the art world.
That's all right. We're not here to talk about photography, are we? My office is over here.
You run into any trouble, you call me.
Got it covered.
Gene Clancy, know I'm coming.
You spoke to him.
Get to it.
Your flight is booked. Leaves in 55 minutes. Ed will be joining you.
Where's Steve?
He went home sick about an hour ago, sir. I'll be filling in.
What's your name again? Edward what?
Meacham.
You drive fast, Meacham?
To talk to me?
Come on in, Zoe. This is Mrs. Tilden, owner of...
She knows who I am.
Mrs. Tilden liked your profile on Catherine Durant.
No, I didn't. I loved it. In depth, uncompromising. Normally, I don't read things before they go to print, but Kathy's a friend. Tell me how you knew she'd be nominated before she did.
You want my source?
Tom says you won't tell him.
I haven't told anyone.
Well, I own the paper.
And I'm very grateful to be working here.
So you're not going to tell me either.
Which do you want, my source or my integrity?
Tom. Move Zoe's piece to the front page of Sunday's edition.
Let me think that over.
You think it over as much as you want, then put it on the front page.
I've worked really hard to gain a foothold with Worldwell. 6 years ago, it was just me and a MacBook.
I understand.
And I had to juggle 2 temp jobs just to pay the rent.
It's your baby. You don't want to let it go.
Well, I just...
And you wouldn't have to, Jillian. All I want is for you to grow what you've already built.
I heard you fired half your staff.
Yes, I did.
That worries me.
I let them go to make room for you.
I'm just not sure we're the right match. To be honest, I'm a little uncomfortable working with someone who's commissioning famous photographers when I can't even buy my volunteers bus fare to the office.
Do you know who Nikki Hemler is?
No.
Nikki owns one of the biggest galleries in Chelsea. She desperately wanted to represent Adam Galloway. I delivered on Adam, and in return, she contributes almost 40 grand a year to CWI. That money goes to impact studies, lobbying efforts, research. Worldwell could benefit from that sort of money, Jillian. And we can benefit from your expertise.
Can I think about it? Of course. We don't have to jump into anything.
I grew up here in the upcountry. Bibles, barbecues, and broken backs. Everything gets just a little bit thicker this far south. The air, the blood, even me. I try to make it down here at least once a month. Every trip is a reminder of how far I've come. I hated Gaffney as a kid when I had nothing. But now, I've come to appreciate it. It's not as suffocating as it once was, except when I have to deal with the sort of nonsense that makes me want to hang myself.
Turn left on route 1.
Don't listen to her. I know a better way.
Yes, sir.
We don't have the money, Frank. The legal bills alone will kill us.
How about a settlement?
I'll look at the numbers.
What's it look like to you?
Like a peach?
No, I mean, what does it really look like?
As mayor, I'll stick with a peach. As a private citizen? Well, it looks like the sun is shining where it shouldn't be.
There's a better way to handle this.
Really, Frank, then what's that?
I'm not trying to start an argument here.
Yeah, you make it sound like I'm in the wrong.
No, you know exactly what you're doing, Owen. You're using this poor girl's death for your own political advantage.
You're the one that fought me when the peach farmers bitched and moaned about me tearing it down. You're the one who took their money.
It's a water tower.
It's ungodly.
Or
this is cut and dry, Frank. I fought to tear it down. You fought to keep it up. That girl's blood is on your hands. And I'm taking you to task for it.
All right, I'll tell you what. Dick Peters is going to retire this term. That means it's an open race in the 4th District. How about I help you lock up that seat?
I'm not looking to make a deal, Frank.
It's not a deal. It's an opportunity.
I'll be just fine.
You may despise me, Orin, but the classy thing to do would have been to invite us up for some of that iced tea. Suggested, not mandated.
We assemble a council of experts who will determine exactly.
No, we are here to say who these experts are, how they'll be chosen.
The president selects the council.
What sort of oversight?
We'd like input on the selection.
Doug, check with Linda.
Calling her now.
Okay.
So now, can we talk about charter schools?
Charter schools are a no-go.
They have to be in there.
You keep them in, we walk.
The same goes for us.
Let's not jump to ultimatums.
Well, let's figure out a way to reduce non-public spending.
All right, give me a few minutes to think about that.
We can't move forward without addressing this point.
I understand, but this is the cornerstone of the bill.
Let's talk it out.
All right, give me 5 minutes, Marty. I'll call you right back.
Oh, no. If we consider settlement as an option, we need to be able to pay for it.
But if we offer a settlement, aren't we saying...
That's my point. We're admitting that the town's responsible for this kid's death.
I say make the peach farmers call.
Oh, man, talk about a shitstorm.
Y'all mind catching me up?
Wayne and Travis want to go to court. I don't think that's a good idea.
We can't be pouring money into a settlement when we can barely afford to run the city.
What do you think, James?
I think that we got to worry about the Peach Farmers Association. If there is a hint that we're blaming the Peachoid, they're going to raise holy.
Who gives a crap? They got to suck it up.
Let them talk.
I'm just saying that we need to keep them in mind.
She was breaking the law. End of story. You can't text while you drive.
Yeah, but all a jury is going to see is a beautiful 17-year-old girl who's now dead.
No offense, Frank, but you just got here. We've been dealing with this for the last week now.
And where's your solution?
What? You think you know better than us?
I'm just trying to be realistic.
Frank, I know you want to swoop down and save the day.
But there's a principle at stake here. We allow ourselves to be extorted because of this
teenager. When Orrin gets a jury to weep a river of snot over this dead girl, when Gaffney goes tits up because you can't afford to pay a seven-figure award in damages, when you all get booted out of office and I lose to Chase, then you can chew my ear off about principles because we'll all have nothing but time on our hands. Until then, you either contribute or you keep it shut, Travis. Now, here's what we're going to do. Gene, how much can we pull together for a settlement if we had to?
About 150.
That'll work. Jamie, get your boys down to the hardware store to build two billboards. Put them out a mile out on either side of the tower. Have them read, drive safely, no texting behind the wheel.
Got it.
And get those up by tomorrow morning.
I'll issue the permits.
And let's stop lighting the thing at night.
The peach farmers aren't going to like that.
Well, how much does the electric cost? $4,100 plus change per month. About $50,000 a year. Jesus. You could put a kid through college on. Let's use that money to start a scholarship fund in her name. Meantime, you tell the association if they want it lit up, they can pay for it.
I'll deliver that message happily.
And do me up a budget and a plan for removing the sphincter.
The what?
It means the emergency valve.
That's interesting. I always thought of it as a clitoris.
But it's on bottom. I believe the clitoris is above the...
But if you imagine a woman on her belly... Enough. I want it done. And Gene... Get me everything you've got on road regulations. County statutes, not municipal. And do you remember that power line business we pulled up at the last election?
Sure do.
Let's make sure we're rock solid on that.
Does this very expensive dinner at least buy me an evening of mind-blowing sexual congress?
It was good, but I don't know if it was that good.
Fellatio, man?
Handjob, maybe. No promises.
Yeah.
Hey, Peter, there's something I need to tell you. I have been thinking lately, you know, it might be good to work somewhere else. So I did some interviews, and the speaker's office offered me deputy LD. Peter.
Christina,
I just thought it could be good, right? If we're going to have any future, to stop this boss-staffer thing and be a real couple.
We are a real couple.
I mean, not have to hide it like we do at the office. And it's a great opportunity, the speaker. Would you hate me if I took the job?
Baby, I want what you want. I won't fight you on this. Not if this is what you feel you need to do.
Really?
Yeah, and you're right. This is a great opportunity. When do you have to tell them by?
But there's no deadline. I don't have to decide right away.
Okay, well, when you do decide, just, you know, help me find a replacement. You know, give me a heads up.
Yeah, of course. I haven't even decided if I'm going to take it. We don't have to talk this through right now. I just thought I'd bring it up. Should we get out of here?
Yes.
Find the parents. You hang back by the car.
It's a big crowd, sir.
If I get shot or stabbed, consoling two grieving parents, I'm a hero from now until the end of time. Let's roll the dice, shall we?
Sir, I can't allow you to go unescorted into all those people.
Allow me? Let's get one thing straight, Meacham. You are never to dictate what I can and cannot do. The only two words I want to hear from you when I ask you to do something are yes and sir. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Good. Then we're going to get along just fine. Mr. and Mrs. Masters, I'm Frank Underwood, your congressman. I'm so sorry for your loss. I cannot begin to fathom.
You're right, you can't. You have no idea.
Forgive me, I don't mean to intrude.
Well, you are intruding.
Dean, please.
What? It's his fault, isn't it?
Anyway, I just wanted to express my condolences and say if there's anything to...
Dean, you don't want to be talking to him. We got legal action pending.
Look, I know what Mr. Chase has been saying. And
nobody invited you. Nobody wants your condolences or your excuses.
Frank, please. You shouldn't have to put up with this right now.
I'm sorry. Well, that went well. Hang on a second. Reverend.
Congressman.
Nice to see you again. I wish it was under better circumstances.
Terrible, isn't it?
It's just terrible. This is so thoughtful what you've organized here.
The least we can do.
Tell me, are the masters in your congregation?
They are. They come every Sunday.
Do you think they'll be at the service tomorrow?
I'd be surprised if they weren't.
I'm wondering, can you do me a favor?
Anything for you, Frank?
Kitchen under the sink. Here's what I think, and I wish I could be bigger than this, but I can't. And I'm being selfish, and I realize it's mostly about me, but fuck it. I have to say it. Please don't take that other job, Christina. Anyway, that's how I feel.
I'm glad you told me.
Charters jeopardize our ability to organize, which is reason enough. But the bigger issue is
that measuring their success...
Charter schools would operate under the same evaluative standards that ever...
Apples and oranges.
No matter how you look at it, you can't use the same standards to compare.
What, you're advocating a more demanding criteria for charter schools than others?
Our point is simple, Frank.
Federal funds should only go to public union school districts.
Yeah, but we've already increased non-charter funding by 10%. The amount going to charter schools is negligible.
It's the precedent, Frank, not the number.
We're setting a lot of precedents, Marty. That's the nature of reform.
Well, some of them we could stomach, some of them we can't.
All right, let's not get bogged down in abstractions. Let's deal with specifics. Corey, can you walk us through it?
There's a three-pronged approach to determining the amount of funding a particular...
Miss me?
Maybe, a little.
What's it been, 15 hours?
No.
Not even long enough to notice you're gone.
Tell that to Marty Spinella.
How's it coming?
It's coming.
Slowly, painfully.
Hey, have we always had tulips in the front yard, or am I slowly going insane?
I planted them last fall.
You did not.
When I was down with you for the campaign.
You've never gardened a day in your life.
Not true. I have gardened exactly one day in my life. You were down in Spartanburg doing some sort of fundraiser. Jean's wife came over with a bucket of bulbs, and next thing you knew, I was down on my knees in the dirt, earthworms and all.
I can't even picture it.
Neither can I, and I was there.
What else? Distract me from giant peaches and dead teenagers.
What else? Oh, I went for a run today. And the strangest... I don't know this woman.
That's interesting.
What is?
Oh, text just came, Zoe Barnes.
Who?
Oh, that reporter from the Herald you met one night.
Oh, her, I remember. Yeah, go if you need to call her back.
No, she can wait. talking to my wife.
That's okay. I'm going to bed soon anyway.
See you tomorrow?
I hope so. Wish me luck.
Merde. Grosse merde.
Tom.
Bonsoir, ma petite pichoille.
Disgusting.
Good night.
Good night. Yeah, all right. That's fine, Corey. Marty?
We're not comfortable with any sort of incentive because on an ideological level we don't believe charter schools create better students who are incentivized, better teachers. You're poor. There has to be some reward for a job well done. It's not a job well done.
Talk ourselves in circles about charter schools, but here's what I propose.
In your profile, you go into great detail about the sexism Durant faced early on in her career.
That's right. When she was first elected, it was still an old boys' club in the Senate.
Journalism used to be that way, too, not so long ago.
I feel really lucky. I've had lots of trailblazers come before me. For instance, my colleague Janine Skorsky was the first woman at the Herald to become chief political correspondent, and that was only 5 years ago.
Has it been those trailblazers who've allowed you to rise so quickly? You've moved up from the Metro pages to the front page Sunday edition.
I don't know that that would be possible if Janine hadn't already paved the way.
So does that mean that the Herald is not particularly progressive?
I think that they are. Tom is very open-minded. He's the reason Janine got promoted.
That's Tom Hammerschmidt, the executive editor.
Yes, we actually call him the Hammer.
The Hammer?
Why? Because he's tough.
How tough?
Tom has very high standards. I love him. He's a great mentor. It can be frustrating at times. He makes you double and triple check things, and you want to get the news out the moment you have it, and he makes you rewrite until it's perfect, but that's what makes the Herald the Herald.
Is that a workable model in the internet age?
Our readers think it is.
No, you have a declining readership.
But I don't lay that at Tom's feet. I think that that's the times we live in, right?
Should newspapers adapt to the times we live in?
It's not that the Herald refuses to adapt. We have an online presence.
Is that maybe not adapting fast enough?
I wouldn't argue with that statement. We can do more.
We've got a special guest with us today. He asked for the opportunity to share a few words with us this morning. Our very own Congressman, Frank Underwood.
Good morning. Thank you, Reverend, and thanks to their choir for that beautiful hymn. I want to read this morning from No. You know what no one wants to talk about? Hate. I know all about hate. It starts in your gut, deep down here, where it stirs and churns. And then it rises. Hate rises fast and volcanic. It erupts hot on the breath. Your eyes go wide with fire. You clench your teeth so hard you think they'll shatter.
I hate you, God! I hate you!
Oh, don't tell me you haven't said those words before. I know you have. We all have. If you've ever felt soul-crushing a loss. There are two parents with us today who know that pain. The most terrible hurt of all. Losing a child before her time. If Dean and Leanne were to stand up right now and scream those awful words of hate, could we blame them? I couldn't. At least their hatred I can understand. I can grasp it. But God's oneness, his cruelty, I can't even begin to... My father dropped dead of a heart attack at the age of 43 years old. And when he died, I looked up to God and I said those words. Because my father was so young, so full of life, so full of dreams, why would God take him from us? Truth be told, I never really knew him or what his dreams were. He was quiet, timid, almost invisible. My mother didn't think much of him. My mother's mother hated him. The man never scratched the surface of life. Maybe it's best he died so young. He wasn't doing much but taking up space. But that doesn't make for a very powerful eulogy now, does it?
I wept. I screamed. Why, God? How can I not hate you when you steal from me the person I most love and admire in this world? I don't understand it, and I hate you for it.
The Bible says in Proverbs, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Lean not on your own understanding. God is telling us to trust him, to love him despite our own ignorance. After all, what is faith if it doesn't endure when we are tested the most? We will never understand why God took Jessica or my father or anyone. And while God may not give us any answers, he has given us the capacity for love. Our job is to love him without questioning his plan. So I pray to you, dear Lord. I pray to you to help strengthen our love for you. Embrace Dean and Leanne with the warmth of your love in return. And I pray that you will help us fend off hatred so that we may all truly trust in you with all our hearts and lean not on our own understanding. Amen.
Your job is to report the news, not be the news.
I was promoting the paper.
You're promoting Zoe Barnes.
Is this about how I said we called you the hammer? Because if that upset you, I apologize.
You're missing the point. I don't want you talking about anything that happens here. Not nicknames, not how progressive we are, not whether we're adapting to the internet. Any thoughts you have about this paper, you keep them to yourself or you bring them to me. You don't get on national television.
I'm sorry, I wasn't trying to...
Don't interrupt when I'm talking.
You can speak to me like an adult, Tom. You don't have to lecture me like a little girl.
You haven't earned the right to be treated as an adult. You think a few front page stories and some FaceTime on TV makes you the next Judy Miller? You've got a long way to go. Don't be so arrogant.
Okay. So you think when a woman asks to be treated with respect, that's arrogance?
Are you accusing me of sexism?
Just making an observation.
No TV for a month.
What?
You heard me. No interviews.
That's completely unfair.
You want to make a no TV indefinitely? We're done. You can go now.
Oh,
Claire Underwood. Can I come up?
Have you seen a doctor?
Giardi's not so bad. It'll pass in another week or so.
You don't have health insurance, do you?
Nope.
I'll make an appointment for you to see my personal GP tomorrow.
Medicine doesn't really do much. You have to let it run its course.
Well, we'll let it run its course under proper supervision. I won't take no for an answer on this.
Claire.
I'll drag you to the hospital myself if I have to.
You're going to the doctor. No argument. Thanks.
They're about to walk. They won't listen to a word I say.
Both unions?
Yeah.
Put Marty on the phone.
Marty.
Yes.
Frank?
This isn't working, Frank.
Marty, you have got to keep them in that room.
Well, they lost their patience, right? They're upset.
You're not in the room, Frank. I'll be back this afternoon.
No, it's too late.
Look, tell them I'll come down on subsidies for charter schools.
Even so, they're angry about the performance standards. We're not even halfway through this thing. There's so much in it that they...
Tell them that I'll roll over on performance standards, 5-year intervals.
It should be you telling them that, Frank.
You here at this table. I know that. You know, I'm doing the best I can, Marty, but I can't be in two places at once. Now, look, I promise you, if you keep them in that room, we will get through this hump as soon as I get back. Marty, you are their lobbyist. You know what's best for them. Save them from themselves.
Okay, I'll see what I can do. Stammer.
Do not let Spinella out of your sight, and lock the goddamn doors if you have to.
You got it.
Here we go.
I know you're a busy man. I hope we're not keeping
you. No, I've got all the time in the world. This is ham, and this is turkey. And some potato salad. Go have a prayer.
Gracious loving God.
Have you had this before?
This is the third time. I'm used to it by now. Well, I'm not used to it, but it beats malaria.
You've had malaria?
In Zimbabwe. That took me out for a month.
You make a lot of sacrifices.
I don't see it as a sacrifice.
You turned down a 6-figure salary at Google to start your own nonprofit. People don't get malaria in Palo Alto.
You do your research.
When it's someone I care about.
Claire, I turned down that job because I would have hated myself. It was a lot of money, but for what? So they could fill their diversity quota with an Asian girl peddling a Stanford degree?
Not just any Asian girl. A valedictorian. Let me offer you what Google couldn't. I know what it is to be capable and beautiful and ambitious and be on people like Sergey and Larry's checklist of things that look good to have on a shelf. I'm not trying to acquisition you. What I see in you is a woman I admire, which doesn't happen often. I want to enable you. I want to clear the way for you so that you can achieve what you want to achieve on your own terms. Thanks for the tea. And I will send a car to pick you up for the doctor tomorrow. When you're back on your feet, do you think maybe we can work something out?
Yes, I think we could.
That's her at junior prom.
Beautiful.
Here she is in her letter jacket. She made varsity as a freshman. I remember the day she found out. Coach called. Jesse starts jumping up and down. Mom, guess what? I'm sorry.
Don't be. It's fine.
Why are we doing this? Honestly, what's to be gained in dredging up all this stuff?
Remembering the good things helps sometimes.
Not when it puts my wife in tears. I appreciate what you said at the church, but it doesn't do us any good. Neither does this.
Well, what can I do to help?
You can't do anything. She's gone.
You're right, I can't change that. But I can make sure the city offers you a sizable settlement.
You mean by yourself?
No, I mean help you avoiding years of court battles. Jessica was going to go to Furman, is that right, on a volleyball scholarship?
Yes, a full ride.
Well, I spoke to the president of the university this morning. We'd like to create a new scholarship in your daughter's name. If you'd like that, it's entirely up to you. But most importantly, we have to make sure that this never happens again. We've got safety billboards going up, stop lighting the tower at night, and we're putting the guardrails in.
She'd have done all that before she ran off the road.
Would you like me to resign, Mr. Masters? Just say the word and it's done. If it will bring you any satisfaction. I asked the Reverend once, what are we supposed to do in the face of so much senseless pain? And he said to me, what else can we do but take what seems meaningless and try to make something meaningful from it?
He's right. That's how God works. Through us.
Will you let me work for you? What you have to understand about my people is that they are a noble people. Humility is their form of pride. It is their strength. It is their weakness. And if you can humble yourself before them, they will do anything you ask.
Tell us more about the scholarship.
Usually work on the weekend.
Well, now I do. There's coffee in the kitchen. You want some?
Peter. Peter. If I decide to stay, it's because it's what I want, not what you want.
I understand.
Which draft are you reading of the written testimony?
The one you sent on Thursday.
I actually changed it on Friday. Can I show you? Yeah, I was thinking that we could start with job numbers and then go to economic multipliers instead of the other way around. What do you think?
That's what it looks like.
Picture this. A 17-year-old girl traveling at 60 miles an hour spins out of control in no traffic. She hits a guardrail, but if she's wearing a seatbelt, which she was, and her car doesn't roll over three times down a 20-foot ditch, which it did, then that young woman is still alive. But you know what? The county administrator didn't build those guardrails, so now she's dead.
We looked up the statute. Guardrails are under county supervision.
Are you trying to turn this around on me?
That's not all, Orrin.
Your easement.
You see, every couple of years, the Piedmont Electric, they apply to bring power lines through Gaffney.
The route comes right through your lot.
Now, Gene and I always fight them off, but this year, if they were to reapply,
Eminent domain?
It'd be such a shame to have to tear down this beautiful home.
Fuck you, Frank. You can't just roll up on my property and act like you own it.
Oh, but I can.
We just did.
I've won this district 11 times. Do you think that's just luck and a firm handshake? But I'll tell you what, I'm not a vindictive person. I don't like for anybody to lose if everybody can win, so I'm going to help you get elected in the 4th. You get to keep your house, I keep the 5th. We put the Peachoid behind us, and everybody's happy. What do you say? Well, that's all right. You think about it. I'm sure you'll do the right thing. Oh, and I'm looking forward to having you in Congress, Orrin. It's always good to have friends on the other side of the aisle. Close your eyes.
Okay.
It's 11:25. Nightline is about to come on. Millions of people are watching. Where are you? Home?
No.
At the studio?
Yes.
And what do you see?
I see lights. I see a camera.
And that little red dot goes on. Tell me what you hear.
I hear my voice.
And those millions of people, what do they hear?
My voice.
And what do they see?
My face.
So you don't need my advice.
Hammerschmidt's gonna freak.
You don't want to work anywhere you're not willing to get fired from, Zoe. Treading water is the same as drowning for people like you and me. Good luck, I'll be watching.
Hey, wait.
Yes?
When do you get back?
When I get back. You'll know. Hello, Nancy.
Welcome back, sir. Linda Vasquez called for you.
Tell her I'll call in a couple of hours with an update.
Very well.
Sir, unless you need anything, Kyle has you covered.
No, go home. You did well this weekend.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, and before you go home, can you do me a favor? Just swing by my house and make sure these get to play.
Yes, sir. And thank you, sir, for being so patient.
Okay.
Episode 3.